There he is! Look up! In the window, across the room! Get him!
I still don't get how he evaded us.
The monks must have warned him. Maybe they're even hiding him somewhere.
That's possible. At least we got the one upstairs. Unless he sprouts wings, we'll be getting downstairs in chains.
Yeah, I'm not so sure. It's taking him too long.
Thank you. Hey, you! Clown! Buzz off!
You, Giacomo. They're waiting for you upstairs. Don't worry. Don't keep them waiting.
Tell me, what do you think about all this?
Giacomo, God be praised. I knew you could do it, but I was still worried. Did you bring the Chronicle? We were successful after all. Just as I hoped. The Chronicle records the whole history of this secret order. This Ordo Eustatalis. I will need a moment to find what we are looking for, but this is immensely interesting. I should probably introduce you. Next to me stands my great friend and advisor. I owe much to him and consider him the most erudite friar in the whole clergy. Honorable Luca Bartolomeo Pacioli.
Don't exaggerate, Leonardo. You underrate my brothers.
That is not my intention, but it is still my opinion. And before us is my disciple and assistant, about whom I have spoken so much. A man possibly brought to me by fate itself to help me carry the weight of my burden. Messer Giacomo Andrea de Ferrara.
I greet you, Giacomo. Please, don't blame Leonardo for his bluntness. He couldn't wait to read the Chronicle. I'm sure you've noticed that when he gets like this, there is no talking to him. Sit down, have a bite. You must be tired after your journey. We have a veritable feast here. Vegetables, pastries, fruit. More vegetables. Well, your master isn't the funnest person in the world, but you surely noticed that as well.
Luca makes fun of me often, but this time I'm really not able to find out where the point is hiding. He would do better to focus on real problems.
See? Just like I said. But seriously, real problems. I'm sure Leonardo told you how, once upon a time, he met Cesar Borgia with members of a secret society. They brought fragmented plans for some strange machine and asked him to construct it for them. At first, he agreed, but when he found out what a terrible weapon the machine could become, he decided not to give it to them.
I see. There can be no more doubt. The secret society was indeed Ordo Eustatalis. They also had plans for the time machine, however incomplete, because in the past they had a similar time machine, so why did they need my help?
Either way, in the end, Ordo Eustatalis took the machine from the tower of Badia Fiorentina. Shortly after Leonardo used it, and just moments after you did as well, Giacomo, when you tried to save your very life from the half-crazed Borgia who took your glove before you came to? I wonder what the story was with the Duke. When they came with the plans, he seemed to have a position of power within the Order, but after your escape to Florence, they didn't cooperate at all. And that's something we should thank Providence for, because until Ordo Eustatalis obtains one of the gloves, they can't use the machine, even if they are able to reconstruct it.
Aha! Here, right at the end of the chronicle, but the year 1465 after Christ came. And for the Order of the Justice, the world was never the same. During that event, their time machine, which they'd called the Gate of the Temple of Wisdom, must have been damaged. That is why they needed my help.
So, to summarize, the Order took Leonardo's time machine, and we don't know where. Borgia took Giacomo's glove, and we don't know where. At least, we still have the one Leonardo came with. Which is broken. Seriously, gentlemen, and I say this as your friend, you should start looking after your things.
That would be an excellent analysis, Luco, if not for the sarcasm and one small mistake that I will correct in a moment. But before that, could you give me the glove?
Here it is. Pretty, but broken.
Fortunately, that does not matter at all. There is one thing I haven't told you yet, my friends. When Borgia came to me all those years ago, he had not only those incomplete plans to build a time machine, but also three ampules with a strange liquid. I don't know where they came from, but they react to open the gate of time. Thanks to them, I can determine where the gate should take us. An ampule is set in each glove, and one in the Oculus Perpetua. Each of them, when set correctly, will allow us to jump through the gate a maximum 15 years in time. This means that if we wanted to travel back to the original time machine in the year 1465, 45 years in the past, we would need all three of them.
So you insist that we need to destroy the original time machine? Completely wipe it from history? No matter the risk, no matter how hard it might be.
As long as the Order has the plans and the will to use it, mankind will never be safe from the invention. I regretted having started working on the time machine, but what do you think would have happened if I had sent them away?
I suppose they would try to find someone else? But I'm sure that nobody else would be able to finish it with such incomplete plans.
Perhaps. Perhaps not. But if not now, then what about in a year, 10 years, 1,000 years? Sooner or later, someone would do it. All it would take would be one moment of weakness and a great deal of naivety or bad intentions, and the world as we know it could cease to exist. No, my friend, trust me that there is no other way. The machine should never have been in human hands.
You are right, Leonardo. I know you have thought about it for a long time, and I trust that your decision is not made lightly. I think I can speak for the both of us when I say that we stand behind you. Well, I think it is high time that we told Giacomo the whole truth about why we met here.
All right. It is true that we don't know where the time machine is, but we know how to get the third ampule because Borgia will surely keep the glove close. And we do know where he is hiding. Just across the street, in the tall building.
Ja couldn't have found a better hiding spot. No normal person would step foot in this neighborhood. Marco was rather surprised when he saw him here. Marco is the jolly man who welcomed you downstairs. He has a lot of friends around, and they learned that Borgia's hideout is very well prepared for, uninvited guests. But right next to it is a burnt pub. Perhaps it would be possible to get inside through that.
Just before you arrived, Marco informed us that Borgia left. We have a unique opportunity to get in and take the glove. Giacomo, out of all of us, you are best suited for this task. We leave it in your hands. Be careful.
trap has sprung, Giacomo. Does this situation remind you of something? I guess it's fate that the betters should have power over the rest. And what about those two nannies of yours? Happily drinking in safety while they sent you into the lion's den. In your place, I would be upset. But I am not interested in your feelings. Just listen to me and then do as you are told. It's in your own interest. Heard you already met the Viper's Tangle, calling themselves a lofty Ordo Justitialis. That's good. What you don't know is that they are currently led by the Pope. He is the puppet master. He would be the one profiting if they got their hands on a working time machine. And I have very personal reasons to hate Pope Julius II. They had everything. I was the most powerful man in all Italy. But fortune is a fickle mistress, or fortuna variabilis. Julius II had his predecessor, and my father, Alexander VI, killed. He usurped the chair of St. Peter and misused the power of his station to take everything from me. My position in the order, my prestige and reputation, and even my domain. And thus, I bet everything on one last gambit. To obtain the time machine and reverse my destiny. I'll give you the glove you seek, but I want something in return. I know you are too much of a coward to kill the Pope. Besides, I wouldn't let anyone take the pleasure from me. But I have another use for you, Giacomo. When my father was still alive, he appointed me to the Ordo Justitialis to find out more about the broken time machine and search for someone who could make it work again. Then that we came to that Leonardo da Vinci of yours. And during this time, I learned something very interesting. Generation after generation of grandmasters inherited this amulet. When the order fell to the Pope's might, the Pope took it, and in time, he granted it to his successors, along with the power over the Ordo Justitialis. It's only a piece of metal, but it is a very powerful symbol. A symbol of supremacy over the Order. And I want it. And that means you, Giacomo, will get it for me. I don't care how you do it. But as I am an eternally gracious man, I'll give you a hint. In the Pope's study is a secret passage which will lead you directly to the amulet. Make one of your nannies help you. The monk was always in the Pope's good graces. He might finally be useful and maybe could even atone for getting you into this mess, don't you think? But that's your problem. As well as getting out of this cage. And don't forget, the amulet for the glove, piece for a piece. When you get it, I'll let you know where we will meet again. This is a token of my goodwill. We will see each other soon. It was a pleasure doing business with you, Giacomo.
Now we must wait before they present us. I would be calmer if Leonardo was with us here, but we couldn't possibly include him as the Order knows him well. And according to Borgia, they are beholden to the Pope. At least we will attract less attention. We must still be careful though. Julius II is cunning as a fox. I indeed know him from before, when he was but a cardinal. He was always straight hard and never afraid to use his brilliant mind to fulfill his goals. Did you know that when he became Pope, he confessed that his new name is not in honor of St. Julius, as most cardinals expected, but after Julius Caesar? He is a good man, and was the situation different, he would make a great ally. It seems we have a few moments, so let's go over our plan, yeah? After I tell the Pope why I came, he will surely want to speak to me privately. Hopefully outside his study. In the meantime, you will have to get there and find the passage leading to the amulet. I will try to distract him for as long as possible, but you must return to the audience room before we are back. I can't wait for this to be over. I'm as nervous as a cat. Just a quick prayer to St. Francis. Or rather, maybe to all the saints. I hope God will forgive me this ruse against my old friend.
Luca Bartolomeo de Pacioli with an escort. The Holy Father expects you.
Garb of a Franciscan, face of a rascal. This could only be Luca Pacioli. It's a pleasure to meet you again, old friend.
Holy Father, you honor me greatly by making time for me. Allow me to introduce my pupil and protege, Giacomo of Ferrara.
This is your pupil? Boy, you should regard your teacher highly. He is a wise man, even if he lacks seriousness. But as Dr. Angelicus said, of all the soul's passions, sorrow is the most harmful to the body. You are surely aware that many duties stem from my station, and I'll have to apply to them by the time the bells toll Evening Angelus. But until that time, you have my full attention. I heard you have important news for me. What is it?
Your Excellency, I heard about the righteous struggle you lead against the Borgia family. Maybe I could do my part to help, turning the proverbial wheel of justice?
Not here, my friend. Let us go for a walk through the gardens. There you can tell me everything.
Giacomo, you wait here. This is only for the Pope to know.
In the meantime, boy, you can pass the time reading. I'm sure you will find a book that will interest you.
That day, God sent Paul II a vision, and he saw where his enemy was hiding. The Pope has called all the devoted to God and the Church, for the time of reckoning has come. Paul II led Christ's faithful to cleanse the sins of Ordo Iustitalis. Before the noise of battle died down, the cowardly members of the order destroyed the gate to the temple. The order fell before the Pope's power, but he was merciful, as the Lord teaches us. And so, Ordo Eustatalis became an instrument in the hands of the faithful, as it should have been from the beginning. Vision, congregation, siege, destruction, mercy, fulfillment.
I never saw anything like this before. Beautiful craftsmanship. I think even the best jewelers in Florence would have a hard time making something of this quality.
Except this is no simple jewelry. And it is obvious that Borgia doesn't want it just because it would look good on his neck.
Yes, our dear Duke. It is clear he'll try and get his hands on the amulet no matter what. We can't forget about the terrible situation he's in and the resolve with which he wants to solve it. And that is one of the reasons why he can never get the amulet. It is the key opening the gate of the Temple of Wisdom, the original time machine, which was once raised in Castle Del Monte by Frederick II. The gate might have been destroyed during the Pope's army attack. Time travel might just be able to get us to the past before that happened.
We will use your time machine to take us to a point before the gate's destruction.
Exactly.
Very well. And do we have any idea where the Order took the time machine?
Everything points to the fact that after they took it from Badia Forientina, it was moved to their residence in Castle Del Monte. And since from the Vatican we know about a secret passage which could take us inside without notice, I think we should make our way there.
Even though we don't have the second glove? Didn't you say we needed all three ampules with the liquid from your inventions to get into the time when the gate was still standing? Maybe we could make a deal with the Duke after all.
Make a deal with Borgia? What are you thinking, friend? I know him for quite a while. But if you don't believe me, try reading what Machiavelli wrote about him. There can be no fair deal with the Duke. And our last attempt to outsmart him almost ended with Giacomo's death. No, as I said, we will set out for Castle Del Monte. I think there is quite a big chance that at the time the Order did not give me all the ampules with mysterious liquid. Where else would they keep it if not at their residence? Sure, it's a risk, but odds are still better than negotiations with Borgia.
Don't be angry, Leonardo. As a servant of God, it is my duty to look for the better in people, and doing my best to find a peaceful solution. But the decision how to do this is, of course, yours.
It's fine, Luger, I understand. But please, trust me in this. We should not linger. We need to prepare for the journey so we can...
Guess they're still here. Let's have a peek.
I saw a light in the windows. I'll have a look from the bridge. You search the courtyard. They have nowhere to run.
Borgia is here. The door, quickly.
I think I found him, my lord.
Well, this is a pickle. Was it just my imagination, or the one with Borgia was the good friend of yours from the Bald Lady?
Marco, that cur!
May the Lord forgive me.
Is this how you welcome weary travelers? That's not very Christian of you. I thought one of you was a monk.
I think it is prudent to stay behind a locked door when an armed traveler tries to break in.
I came for the amulet. It is definitely not in your interest to make me wait. Give it to me now. Oh, don't be afraid. I remember our deal. I have the glove. You can keep it for a while, just until you make the modifications needed so it takes me to the gate to the Temple of Wisdom. After that, I'll take it back if you don't mind.
That doesn't sound as our deal at all. You're acting like a common brigand, Duke.
You want me to act like a brigand? I can do that. Open these doors or I'll break them down. This is your last chance.
Well, that was about a peaceful solution. Luca, any other ideas?
I might have. It's not looking good for us, but we have two advantages over those rogues. First, there is another exit which they don't know about yet. And second, Giacomo has the miraculous device Leonardo made. And the Duke cannot defend against something he has no clue about.
You are right, Luca. I almost forgot about Oculus Perpetua. Use it, Giacomo. If you flank them, you will surely find a way to take them out of commission. Maybe you could use the cart by the well in the garden. And if they're trying to break the door, they must be standing right in the middle of the tracks.
You had your chance, but you squandered it. Do not expect me to find any mercy for you after this. Find something to use as a battering ram and take care of this door. If you're quick, I might be generous.
That was a terrible hit, but both of them will recover in time. They just lost consciousness. And the glove survived without major damage as well. Which means we can focus on what's really important when we get to Castel del Monte.
Great. I will return to the workshop and make the preparations. You and Giacomo move those to somewhere warm. When they come to, we will be long gone.
They should establish horseback travel as an elaborate form of torture. My whole body aches. But according to the sketch, we should be in the right place. I hope there would be an inn or something. Oh.
I was afraid I'm the only one weary from the journey. But it seems only Giacomo is in form. Well, he'll see what it's like in a few years. Giacomo, if you feel you can, look around for a bit. The entrance to the secret passage must be on this clearing. Luca and I will need to take a moment of rest.
Look, Leonardo, your apprentice doesn't want us to enjoy our moment of respite. He found the entrance already.
Well, somebody had to do it when the old guard rests. But don't worry, there will be enough time to rest. After all, somebody must stay and make sure nobody surprises us from behind.
And should you be that someone? We could do it with Giacomo. You sacrificed enough for this.
Thank you, Luca. But that is the reason why it can't be me. The last 15 years of my life culminated to this moment. Not to mention that I am only amending my own lapse of judgment.
Leonardo, I understand. May the god protect you and light your way. After all, Franciscans aren't best known for their stealth skills. I wouldn't be of much help.
I left my cloak on the saddle. Take it if you get cold. And don't worry, friend, I believe we will meet again soon, whether in this time or another. I feel I'm calmer now, knowing that no matter what happens, Luca will be fine. Look, there's an alcove over there. I think this one is beyond our help. In
interesting lighting system.
This is a very interesting machine, Giacomo. Some kind of storage crane. It had to be laying here for decades, but seems pristine. I have a feeling we'll find a use for it. I'll wait here in case you needed my help to push it.
Thank you.
Oh! I won't lie to you. This was quite shocking. We are definitely not coming back this way. But that doesn't matter. We need to continue forward. The rail can be used as a ladder. After you, Giacomo. Now this is what I call good masonry. And the elevator, given its age, the technology is very advanced. I'm sure it leads directly to Castle Del Monte. The mechanism looks quite reliable. I think it could be repaired. Giacomo, I would need a stepladder or a stool. I'm afraid that it is too high for me. Would you be so kind? Fascinating mechanism. I can't. Giacomo, do you think you could get me a shaft like this one? But straight. Or just find a way to straighten this one out?
It seems the mechanism is fine. But the cogs are a bit rusty. Could you also get me some oil? Thank you for the help, Giacomo. Now all you need to do is get in here and turn that wheel over there. Go for it. Our goal is in sight. It seems the elevator lifted us into a storeroom, which was once used to supply the whole keep. But I noticed some old documents here as well. I'll try and look through them, and maybe I'll find something useful. Giacomo, you should use the time to find a way to the other side of that door over there. My time machine only into suitably large space. We should find some large hall. Maybe here in the middle. No, that's the courtyard. But maybe that's fine. The gate would fit there easily. I see you were successful. Well done. We're in luck. According to the plan, the gate leading to the courtyard is just behind this door. You go first, Giacomo. But be careful. Look, Giacomo. The stolen time machine really ended up in the courtyard. It is so close, but getting through the grating won't be easy. If we were able to somehow... The machine is well guarded, but I'm surprised they built it vertically. But I might have an idea why. They will need to mix the fuel for the machine similarly as I did in Badia Fiorentina. But here with the tanks above the machine, they let gravity do most of the work in transporting the liquid. It is also important for the machine to turn quickly, and they need an engine for that. Oh. I see. It's right under the makeshift roof on the right.
It seems they took the boiler from my workshop. We will need to split up. I will go to the roof and find a way to those tanks above. I remember well how to mix the fuel right and what to do if something unexpected happens. I doubt the Order solved these problems on their own. Meanwhile, you, Giacomo, will enter the courtyard and light up the boiler. After all, you already did this once. But what about the guards? We'll have to improvise. If it comes to worst, I will distract them from above. Either way, you'll have to act fast. Now, we need to get to the roof. In the back of this room is a stairway which should lead us directly to the roof. And the controls for this gate should be right above us. But I do not see any door that will lead us there directly. Well, we'll see when we get in there. We'll get no further without a key. Let's try that door over there. Behind this wall is the mechanism that could be used to open the metal gate on the floor below. You won't get it from here. But don't worry, I have a solution. Here. The plan of the keep. I've marked the controls and sketched a way you could use it to get there. You should try using the gallery above the courtyard. That should help you evade most of the rooms, which will surely be full of guards. You should also be able to get there from the study we just searched. Did you notice the window above the bookcase? You must use it to get outside. Meanwhile, I'll get on the roof and take care of the fuel. If necessary, I'll buy you some time so you can get to the machine unnoticed. I'm sorry, Giacomo, but the main responsibility will be yours. I'd like to enter the time machine with you, but if anything gets in my way, you need to finish our quest at all costs. Here, take the amulet.
Our sentries spotted movement on the roof.
Then what are you waiting for? I want the intruder in chains before I get there.
Yes, sir.
Have either the devil's luck, or Luca prayed for us to the Lord. Because the guards left without me having to do anything at all. Giacomo, we are only one step away from success. First, light the boiler, just like you did in Badia Fiorentina. I'll do the rest by pumping the fuel into the machine when it's spinning. Seems that fortune really favors us. We did it, Giacomo. In the end, we will be able to go together.
Not so fast, Master. I implore both of you to avoid making any sudden moves. One of my great passions is hunting rabbits, and they are, as I presume, quicker than you two. I guess there is no cause for all that excitement now, don't you think?
Please wait, Duke. I'm sure we could somehow.
One day you're up, the next you're down. I could write a book on this. But now, is finally the moment when I'll ascend to the stars, and you, sadly, will move in the opposite direction. I'll tell you how this is going to play out. You will drop the amulet on the floor and slowly retreat. I will thank you for all the preparation you made on my behalf, and... what's that? Oh, God damn it!
Forger threw the weapon down! Drop the weapon! Don't play with us! Drop the crossbow!
Drop it! Are you deaf? I will gladly cut you unless you drop him. I'm warning you!
What are you waiting for? Go!
Shoot him, you fools!